Hello and welcome to the Learning Square. In this series of Introduction to Python, I will continue my discussion on object-oriented programming and we will look at sorting of list of instances. So let's first revisit our sorted method that we had. So Python has an inbuilt method called sorted to be able to sort lists. So if I have a list like this and if I give sorted on A without giving any other keywords, then this is what I get. This is according to the ASCII values of all the strings that I have. Now if I give something like this, I say sorted and I give key with a function already defined in Python called length, then according to the length the sorting is done. So this is 2, this is 3 in length and this is 4 in length. So my sorting is now done according to the length of the strings that I have here. I could also write the same function like this. So we've discussed lambda before. So lambda takes the input x and returns the length of x and this is now the key. So the same output will be got. Maybe I have a list of another strings here, strs. I define my own function on this argument s and I return the last element. So this is actually taking an iterable data type here and it is returning the last element of that iterable data element. So here what will be returned? C, B, D and A will be returned for all these elements if I run this function on strs. Now I'm trying to sort this according to the key given. So the sorting will be done based on the last element. So you can see A is the smallest, then B. It really doesn't matter what's there in the first place. My sorting is done according to the last element. So my sorted is pretty useful and I could give my functions as keys and do the sorting. Now suppose I want to sort a list of instances. This is also not fundamentally different from what we've been doing in the past. So I just need to provide a key function here. So let's look at this new class that I have created. This is according to the COVID data these days. So I have a city detail. Then I have a constructor here where I'm giving the city, the state and the number of people infected here. I'm passing it to the constructor and I'm returning in the values of the city, state as well as number of cases here will be returned as a number. So I've created a few instances here for Kanpur, Uttar Pradesh, 11 cases, Agra, Uttar Pradesh, 73, Mumbai, Maharashtra, 910. So you could have as many data as elements as you want. Now I have created a list of all these elements here. So I write a function here. First understand what this is doing. So sorted COVID data. So I'm taking this data, this list here. I'm giving lambda and it is returning me x dot n. So this is n would be the number of cases here. So it's returning me the number of cases value here. And I'm sorting the data as per the number of cases here. And then what am I printing? I'm printing the C value, which is the city value. So let's run this. So you can see Kanpur, Agra, Mumbai in the ascending order. So we had given numbers 11, 73, 910. So this is returning me in the similar fashion. If I would have given this as maybe the city name, let's run this. So you can see Agra comes first, A, K and M. According to the alphabetical value, this is now sorted. So I have been able to iterate on these values. So I have been able to sort the list of these instances. So this brings us to the end of this lecture. I will see you in the next one. Thank you.